Sometimes we tear ourselves apart trying to work on our weaknesses to make them go away. But our weaknesses can be one of the best tools to help us to become better. And here's why. This is one of my favorite verses in all of Scripture. It's in Ether chapter 12, verse 27. And it says, "And if men come unto me, I will show unto them their weakness. I give unto men weakness, that they may be humble. And my grace is sufficient for all men that humble themselves before me. For if they humble themselves before me and have faith in me, then will I take away their weaknesses." I didn't read that right, did I? In fact, I purposefully misquoted it. The last part actually says, "For if they humble themselves before me and have faith in me, then will I make weak things become strong unto them." It doesn't say he's going to take away those weaknesses. He says, "I will make them strong unto them." So let's talk for a minute about one way that that might happen. There's a principle in gardening that's not very well known, but when it's understood, it can be really useful. It's the idea of understanding the purpose or the need met by certain plants in the garden. We often think of weeds as an inherently bad thing, that we just need to tear them out and keep tearing them out, throw down the herbicides to get rid of them. But weeds can have a very important purpose. They're fulfilling a need in the soil. For example, bindweed, as we sometimes call morning glory, serves a purpose of protecting the soil and maintaining moisture in the soil by covering it. In order for an ecological system to maintain itself well, it needs to be able to hold moisture. And often, a weed will grow in to protect the soil and make sure it can hold moisture by blocking it from being immediately evaporated as soon as it gets warm. If I, as a gardener, recognize that and see a bunch of morning glory or bindweed showing up in my garden where I don't want it, I can tear out the bindweed and put something else in its place that meets the same need. Now, the reason I bring this up is because our weaknesses can be the same way. Neil A. Maxwell once said, "Meek introspection yields bold insights." And I want you to think about that as we talk about this idea. Let's say, for example, that I have a bad habit of playing too many video games. I recognize that it's a habit, maybe it's even an addiction, that it's something that I really need to overcome. Of course, my first thought is going to be, I need to stop playing video games. And that's good. It's like pulling out the bindweed. Of course the bindweed needs to come out. But the bindweed was filling a purpose. So is your addiction to video games. And if you can think about it and look closely at what exactly need was being met, you can find something else to meet that need that's more productive. Now, this is going to look very different for every person, but let's say for myself, I look at it and say, well, why do I have this addiction? What is it about video games that I really need to be doing it? I may think and look at it, well, what is it that I like about them? I like the sense of being able to move forward and advance and have these little rewards all the time that are kind of helping me feel like I'm accomplishing something, even though maybe deep down I know I'm not. That immediate feeling of, ah, I did it, ah, I made it, ah, I got one. Sometimes the brain craves those kind of things because that need to succeed, that need to advance, that need to grow is not being met elsewhere. So if I recognize I need to feel success, I need to feel little rewards, little things that are working in my life, maybe I could look and say, maybe I should take up learning to play the guitar. By learning to play the chords, every time I play something right, I'm going to get that rush of feeling of accomplishment, like something meaningful has happened. I'll also have emotion involved as I begin to play things right. And I'll develop a talent that could be really a blessing to other people and myself. So if I give up the video games and immediately start learning to play the guitar, I may be able to meet that need and also develop a feeling of success and growth. Remember that the scriptures say that the Lord can make weak things become strong unto us. Maybe that's it. If I have a weakness for needing that success, needing that feeling of accomplishment in small ways, I can meet that intentionally. Instead of just allowing my life to just go about and what feels good I do and what doesn't feel good I don't do, I can be more deliberate about it. And by being deliberate about it, I can overcome that weakness, and suddenly I'll be thinking, what was so good about video games? Look what I can do now. And let's not forget that the Lord says that His grace is sufficient for all men that humble themselves before him. Because if they humble themselves before him, then they will be able to make weak things become strong. Remember that his grace, the Lord's grace, is his enabling power. He can make us more than what we are. He can help us overcome, not just get rid of the bad, but replace it with good. And by taking a deliberate approach to it, it becomes much easier and much more fulfilling. I'm Chaz Hathaway. Thanks for listening.